Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, need those.
JT Thomas.
I guess that's
Anything. Did doubles with Ryan Coe, 13 specialist. Then Harry Nottingham, I think, played a goal.
Yeah. We should put out that Sheps was only playing in the back doubles because he's too good to play the singles. It's an important thing to note here.
All practice nonetheless, though, surely.
Harry Jones is fully ranked. Christy Sauce, Noah, with Adam Sheps, Shepherd, ranking 28th in England. So this should be an easy game for the boys. Nice win to start with.
Yeah.
For training.
Clearly the tournament didn't pay off. It's looking up to like
I personally...
Neck.
In his dissertation, which involves a badminton study.
Oh yeah, have you done that yet?
I've taken part, so.
How? Yeah, it's VR, isn't it?
Yeah, so you put on these glasses with little cameras in that track your eye movement, and then you know he does some smashes at you, a bit harder than he's doing against the Cardiff Met players, which we're able to cope more. And then you go into this VR headset where there's some magical colours you look at, and practice some defence, and then you go back with the like spy glasses and. There you go, so that's what Adam Sheps is doing at the minute.
No doubt perfecting the smashes before the...
And his defence, you know, with his VR set must be top notch.
Still all looks pretty comfortable for both players, though. Can't tell, to be honest.
I have to say, I've never seen Harry Jones look so relaxed on the court.
Nah, a bit of frustration from the Cardiff Met player as well. He doesn't look too happy with himself.
Yeah, which is to be expected when you're playing such a good player.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, was that a mistake from Sheps?
Rare mistake, but it did happen.
He doesn't look too. You've returned a few of Sheps' smashes, haven't you?
A couple. Yeah. But even then, I wouldn't back myself. It's a tough game whenever you're against him.
I have to say, he looks more relaxed here than he does against you.
It's just a symptom of playing me, you know. I don't think I've ever seen anyone come off a court looking happy with themselves.
Oh. I think Harry Jones just lost a point. I think that's two points he's lost.
If we're putting in score predictions now, are we saying single digits both? Do you reckon?
I think Sheps here, we're looking at a 9.
A 9, but could, not hitting double digits.
Could kiss the double digits.
I think both of them would be disappointed if they hit double digits.
I agree. Oh. Look at that. All the finesse and elegance that you would expect from Harry Jones. Oh. That's the first game done for Sheps and Harvey Sawyer. And we can also compete. Great to say, I have to say, to see so many people support him. This is, you know, just great.
It's a good way to ease into the day, you know. Start off fast team, first, I mean, you can go on to support the other teams later on in the day, you know.
Oh, that's the first point of this set conceded by a very own Shep, so somewhat disappointed with that. I'm sure he is too.
Don't think it's an omen to come though.
He's staying calm.
Yeah, he doesn't look disappointed with himself. Tight net exchange.
Wow.
Big smash.
Good rally that.
Oh, strong defence from the Cardiff Met. Oh. Peeing up into the game.
I can see that our coach Pete Rush has just arrived in the venue. If we're lucky, we might get a few. Approaching up the stairs. Do you want to comment?
maybe after the game.
From our coach here. Obviously not as good a coach as Coach John Paul that we've got down there.
That's beautiful. I don't know my message.
More support arriving. Another point won by Harry James. I mean, I don't know what to say at this point. Like, you can see our players.
Well, it can only look Sam and hot for this tournament, Dan Kite, coming up against you on the other side of the net.
Yeah, I mean, Dan Kite is our little Welsh dragon, probably the best Welsh player in this room. even if it is Cardiff Met.
Yeah, you got to think, there could be a conflict of interest there, really, you know. Yeah. Is he willing to toss for the national pride?
Welsh firecracker.
Or has the...
support those dragons. there is that risk.
But you know him and Anthony were actually playing in the doubles last weekend together. So, yeah, no. Well, they started late because... I think they were like the last doubles pairs to play. The far front. You wouldn't. But yeah, I don't think the doubles went quite as well for either of them. But they did have some very tough competition. So hopefully they'll both be able to bring some wins back today, which they weren't able to at the weekend.
Yeah, hopefully.
Oh, his knees. To be fair, I think Harvey done off the that one as well. Beautiful.
I mean, it is pretty poor from Harry Jones, that.
No.
You can see there's quite
Sometimes you just got to kind of put your hands up and say, it's a nice, you know.
A stern look from Pete Bush over there in the corner.
No doubt he'll be working on that in training later on today.
Yeah. Oh. Ooh. Poor language from the opposition there. We do have to apologise to any of our listeners. Oh. And another point to Harry James. Have you got these scores yet, Adam?
Unfortunately not. I'm still waiting on Noah to send them through. It's poor on his end. His attention after these ones. I will say though, the game with Sheps is looking at least a little bit competitive. So Cardiff haven't come completely empty-handed.
Getting the scores in now. So Harry Jones won the first set 21-2. Slightly lower than our prediction there, 21-5. And Adam Sheffield won 21-7.
Let's start though.
No, I could have given a good game. All
It's the first game being the first second two. We'll set it on. So what's the feeling for doubles? You said you saw them in the warm-up, it didn't look too strong for Cardiff.
I know that our player Dan Kite is phenomenally strong.
I mean, yeah, Dan Kite's been looking good. That and Sam have obviously been playing the whole season together, so they've got a lot of chemistry going, they know what they're doing, how they're moving.
It's an exceptional partnership.
As well, you've got been playing together. Much success in history at the end of the day, though, not the results. That's what we that's what they bring.
Be quite good.
You got questions lined up.
Got all questions lined up. I mean, what is there to ask?
Yeah.
Do you think you were the right man for the job?
I'll pass.
Let's start with Adam Sheps. So I'm here with Adam Sheps.
Hey. All right.
How did you find that game?
It was good fun, yeah, good crowd.
What was the score in that second set? We didn't.
Seven, yeah.
Seven again.
Consistent play. It's good.
He had some good shots there.
He had a good smash sometimes. You know, like when he brought it out, like some. Yeah, I tried a flick a couple of times, and he just like smacked it down, hit a winner. So.
You know, we could see that Coach Pete had quite a stern look.
Yeah, he looked a bit concerned. I've got to say. Yeah.
I mean, there's no panic here on the back side.
No.
There's a lot of focus on Harry Jones's game.
Yeah.
Did you catch any of that?
No, I was quite focused on my game. Yeah.
I'm sure you'll have a little catch up now so he can give you some pointers. And
yeah, yeah. I'll see what he says, what he thought about that game.
But enjoy your first game then.
Yeah, it was good fun. Had a good time, good match.
Our viewers at home can't see this, but you look pretty relaxed.
Always the waiver, right?
Honest, I don't know, I'm sweating a bit.
The
so.
Commentators look like they're sweating a bit more, so I'm not too worried.
Yeah. How's the commentary going?
Commentary, you know, managed to talk through the whole game, so.
Yeah.
All our listeners are probably very happy with that.
Yeah.
It was a good game to watch, well played.
Yeah, thank you.
So what's next for you? You've got another single?
Yeah, I guess I've got the guy Harry played.
Do you think you're going to beat Harry's scores?
I don't think so. I think that's quite difficult scores to beat.
No, I think could we be looking at a donut here?
No, I don't think so.
You're going to try?
I'm just gonna have a good time, go out there, have a yeah. Yeah.
How do you feel about the doubles? What do you think about these?
I haven't seen the Cardiff players, but I mean our Bath players are quite strong, so.
You were actually the select of the team today, didn't you?
yeah. Out of the limited players. You answered my poll. Who could I have picked? That's true, I could have. That's true. I had no idea what the opposition would bring, you know. Maybe they had some secret top players in there. Oh really? Get me some more participants. I have, yeah. I've done, 120 times 25 smashes practice in the last couple of weeks, so, yeah.
Have you yourself had a go with the VR and doing the defence?
I have, yeah, been practicing.
You can tell it really paid off.
It definitely did. I'm not sure I would have won without doing my VR practice.
That is the view that we had.
Yeah. Yeah, made a big difference. Oh, they've started.
And that's a big smash from our Welsh Dragon.
Oh, the Cardiff players are on the attack. Oh,
Yeah,
good start.
Have you got any fears or concerns that we might not win these?
Wow. Oh, yeah. Shall I pass back to Adam?
Yeah, I'll let you.
I'll let you prepare mentally for your next game.
Have a drink.
A bad start, to be fair, but we're actually looking competitive.
How do we hold this?
Right. Just hold it.
Hello guys. How are we?
How did you find that first game?
I thought it was really fun, you know. The crowd were great.
What was your second
score there? So I won 2 and 3.
Three.
So.
How did you feel about that performance?
I'm quite disappointed that, you know, the second set was more points to him than the first, you know. Too many errors, you know, lack of concentration maybe. Yeah, definitely potential, but I thought, you know, a zero is sort of not very entertaining for the crowd, you know.
I don't know, I think...
You're going to try for it in the next game?
I think the next guy's actually alright, no? Sheps, like, he's actually like...
He's got a big smash.
Some good smash. Yeah, we have words from the big man himself, James.
Yeah.
The other part of that
player
is actually alright.
Yeah, he is.
What are you scared about?
Yeah.
How do you feel about our doubles, boys?
I feel like this one on, what, court?
Court two.
I think the one on court two is probably the best match we're going to see today, like close wise. Yeah, definitely. Great shot from David there. Jesus. No, I'm not expecting single digits because I know, well, that's Sam Jenkins and Jono Ewins from back in the day on the tournament circuit. They used to be on absolute flames. Yeah, they used to be quality players. You know, a lot of people give up because of like GCSEs, A levels.
That's what happened with the two commentators here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you for.
It's all right. Thank you very much.
Good luck in your next game.
Yeah, appreciate it. We'll try and get that donut.
Yeah, you can try and beat Sheps' scores of 7 and 7.
Okay, yeah. I'll try that.
And we told Sheps that he's got to beat 2 and 3.
Yeah, I think... Doable. Yeah. They're both very doable.
We also noticed the same with Sheps' game. There were a couple of mistakes that you made in there where your Coach Pete, was giving you quite a stern look.
Quality coach, by the way.
No claps at all, which... Clearly a reflection of your player.
Yeah. You know, the double clap means that you need to get a move on, you know, you need to wake up.
I mean, you had nothing.
Yeah. Not even a reaction.
Not even a reaction, just a stern.
You didn't even say well done.
That's cold. It's probably not very impressive.
Yeah, no.
David has had a break, one of his usual breaks.
Yeah, he loves a break at 11.
Well, yeah, when you're nearly a pensioner, you do.
Yeah, he's quite the man of age, isn't he?
I just like to... publicly apologise to David. It slipped out of my mouth.
Right, well, thank you. Thank you for allowing me to interview.
Appreciate it. We'll see James again in our final
two coming.
So, we've one more question, actually, for our staff here. Would you also like to apologise on behalf of the Cardiff Met player for some poor language in the middle of that game?
I didn't say anything.
No, the Cardiff Met
player. Oh, yeah, sorry. The viewers at home, we're really sorry for any offensive language that may have been said. It may have been my fault, you know. Well, you know, just absolutely slaughtering the opponent. Maybe that's. Yeah. Maybe just cut down on the social life, and you know, get some training in. You know. Yeah. Get some performance training in. What's that? Well, you know, there's a big social tonight, huge one, you know. If you're listening at home, you should really come along. Highly recommended pub golf. It will be an absolute mayhem, chaos. Oh, what a dive. It's a shame you didn't get over there.
You can watch that on camera.
It's that rustiness from quitting the tournaments back in the day.
Oh, these boys are going to be dancing on court three. Oh.
Court one, not so much.
That's court three, actually.
I will save her at least if
I'd have
in the tough game. Don't know, could go one of make him struggle mentally, or it's gonna make him power through a
Welsh firecrackers secured the first set there as well.
Not too much of a comfortable in their game. A big kill from Anthony as well. I think he pinged for player, but a little apology. David didn't even go for it. They just don't want to talk to you, clearly. I think that's the first game done on court.
So the first score just far, but still single digit. So and score just just coming in for the other game. 21-9 to David and Anthony.
29 or 21-19?
21-9. We think. But we're pretty confident it was 21-9.
If it is 9, then the game looked a lot.
Quite a fast game. So, like, yeah. There were some good rallies.
That's definitely got to settle the nerves for if you come out single digits in the first game, you know, looking pretty chill.
21-8 and 21-9. We won 21-8 and 21-9. Yeah, we've won everything. All single digits. I have to say, there's some clear aggression coming from the Cardiff players. Probably hitting double digits, but I'm sure they'll make up for it with a few.
Oh, good defense.
What's the word?
Just wide as well.
Oh,
Anthony's looking pretty good.
Frank was trying a little round the back block there. I think we seem to be losing the crowds. I think we might have to have a word with our our coach here, telling the players to make the games look a bit closer and more intense. But not much we can do about that.
So picture yourself here, 2 years, playing varsity. How are you?
I might be too good, I think
too good.
That's my only concern.
You know, it could be you and Dev on court once again.
Me and Dev. Dev is a serious athlete. A frequent player for the men's thirds. With some poor performances recently.
I mean, I was talking about chemistry on court. I think you two have got some of the best chemistry I've ever seen. It's just unbreakable bond on and off the court.
I mean, from our Bath Badminton Awards, we do actually have the best bromance in the club, which goes to Sam, the tall one on court 3, and Harry Jones, the absolute beast we saw earlier.
Weren't you nominated for that?
I think there was a few nominations.
I think I nominated you and Dev for that, to be honest. Seemed like a good call.
A good decision. Should also comment that it's a really popular game. This is so boring. I think this just goes to show that singles is a more popular game to view than doubles.
You're saying that as a doubles player as well, though.
I am a doubles player, but that's because I'm lazy, you know. I mean, if you watch these, the boys are hardly moving.
Yeah, but I mean, you could say that about the...
We got a clap there from Pete Bush, like... That's more valuable.
Coach Pete and Coach JP talking with each other, though. Could be passing on tactics together. If you were sat down there with them now, what would you be saying? What would you be giving as advice to the players?
I mean, I'd say like they should just win. You know, nothing else matters.
I mean, you're saying try and make the games more exciting. What's your aim there?
I think, you know, a donut would be more exciting.
Would it? You gotta ask though. Would it be more interesting if they're getting no points? You know, maybe. Yeah, David's just putting that away though. No doubt about it.
Big old clap from the crowd there. Unfortunately, our mics are so focused on our voices, you couldn't hear it.
Yeah, that's the first doubles done. Another win, 3-0 up across all of the games.
We'll just get these scores in for you. What a great time to start your morning. Way to start your morning, not time. Time is currently 12:04. We're here in the SDV.
Stop.
Oh my god, very fucking hell.
You're more than welcome. We definitely recommend.
It's looking fairly even. I'm not sure what the score is exactly.
I imagine it's
coming up on the halfway point for the second game. Pretty laid back movement to the smash there.
Oh.
They've got chances, to be fair. It's just
I mean, yeah, we should
discipline to put it away at the moment.
It's a strong doubles pair, this, we have to say.
But like, if they do start putting away these chances, you do start to have to worry a little bit for David and Anthony.
Well, definitely.
But when you're hitting shots like that, you can't worry too much.
Little backtrack there from you.
Yeah, no.
Worry, don't worry. You heard it here first. Words from our one of our
question is,
strongest players.
When is he going to pull out one of his signature drive serves?
Or his dodgy calls.
Or dodgy calls. He's definitely going to have one of those somewhere.
Oh. I think the Cardiff Met boys are performing well here. We shouldn't be too worried though, because after all we are Bath. Big claps there, big claps from the crowd.
The hype man.
Oh, massive crowds coming in.
Oh, really nice that shot as well.
Mm.
Starting to look like a bit more in control of the game now. It's not as tightly contested. I think they stopped giving the attack to Cardiff as much, and they can't do too much with it anymore.
I'd say this mic is getting quite heavy in my hand. So. Oh. Two more players coming in to watch the game. Crowds here are wild.
Do you want to put a couple of words in?
Who's it going out to?
The world.
Worldwide broadcast, man.
I might just go see if we can get a comment from our winning doubles pair.
No, go on, I'll talk with Joe.
Fantastic.
What are you saying?
Strong performance so far.
I mean, yeah. Do you think there's any threat from Cardiff Met watching the game now?
Absolutely not.
The if you're putting yourself down on the court right now, score prediction, what are you saying?
I don't see them getting above 5.
Above 5? I back yourself more. I'm putting no more
this
than
match.
3.
I just got here.
This match is right.
Yeah, no, these guys are actually, it's actually a good game.
Oh, okay. It's good, strong performance so far.
Singles, not so much. I think we had 2 and 3 from Harry and 7 and 7 from Shep.
That is a beautiful performance, showing the Bath dominance.
But it's looking good. All right, Dan wants to give Sam a go on that mic.
Oh, do I lose it?
Thank you. So I'm here with Sam.
Hello.
You have to hold the mic quite close to your mouth.
Hello.
You don't shout, that was in our briefing sheet for those of you listening at home. Really great role if you're ever interested. I think we've just taken the win.
Have we?
Have we? I don't know.
We've taken the win. We won the first set.
We won the first set. We won the second set. How was your game? How did you find it?
It was some thrilling rallies.
And what were the scores in those two sets?
21-7, 21-3.
21-3, and you didn't feel like getting a donut in that game?
We tried our best, but unfortunately I missed my serve.
You missed your serve?
Not good enough.
You can watch that back on the video. I'm sure it's available.
Learn from next time.
Sam misses a serve. You won't get that from any of the other players.
No way.
They're too good.
They are.
Did you have fun on court?
We loved it. Dan was a bit good.
Well, Dan, as we call him, he's our little Welsh firecracker.
Yep.
Strongest Welsh player in the room.
By far.
It's Cardiff Met we're playing. I'm sure they've got some Welsh players in there. But
He's too good.
So good enough. What did you think of the hype man? Sort of disappeared, didn't he?
I know, I was loving him. It was a bit.
He left.
And then he left. He got wasn't thrilling enough.
Do you think we should get someone else on there?
I think we should get Dan on.
Get Dan Kite.
We should get Dan Kite.
Dan Kite. Dan Kite on here or Dan Kite on the hype man?
Oh, what about both?
What about both? That is a shout. I mean, let's get Dan Kite over here.
Just check the Instagram.
Come on, you little Welsh firecracker.
I posted the link on the Instagram.
Will you be at the social tonight?
I will.
As you should.
I will.
Oh, slightly hairless. So I'm here with Dan Kite.
Hi.
How did you find that game?
It was good.
It was good.
You look pretty comfortable. I saw some really nice splashes, you know.
Thank you. Yeah.
And what do you think of Sam Cooke messing up his serve?
It's unacceptable, really. But we move on.
I heard you had some quite good runs recently.
Yeah.
And you know, you're practically a Welsh international player, aren't you?
No, but no.
But yeah, like.
No.
That is the answer. A bit like Vicky Pollard, this boy's got all the answers we need. How do you.
Should get the win.
Do you think we'll get a donut? 21 love?
Hopefully.
Thank you for your comment. I'll let you get back to your partner. Have some chill time.
Good luck for the next match.
I'm going to back over now to Joe for some continued commentary from Adam and Joe. One of my favourite.
To all of our fantastic 11 viewers, I want to say a great thank you. Thank you for watching.
Do you mean we've got 11 viewers?
I checked on YouTube. Oh,
just check. We've got viewers!
We've got viewers. So the players are warming up right now. Looking like a strong start. They've already won their first games.
I mean, yeah, it wasn't that close, to be fair. It was pretty chill. I will say, though, the guy that Harry is playing on the court closest to us, he is the better player, and he's got a nice smash. So I wouldn't be surprised if he hits a couple winners straight through him. Yeah, one on the right-hand side, not quite so much. I will say there was a bit of mental weakness in the last game. He was getting a bit frustrated with himself. And when you're playing someone like Sheps, who's just permanently in control,
he's in your head.
It's over for you. It is over for you.
Strong start from Harry. I think that is freedom.
Yeah, he did say he's on the fence about a donut. He wants to obviously set a new record. But at the same time, you know, he's all about keeping the crowd entertained. So.
Love that man.
A bit of
player's player.
He's a player's player. That's exactly what he is. Always. Donut's already off our guards for after a shot like that.
Harry has already lost a point.
Now, as a.
He's gone in his head a bit. He's a bit shaken.
As a men's twos player, and we've got David and Anthony playing varsity today.
Yeah, I know.
What's your insight onto that pair? Well, playing really alongside them, what do you know?
We're losing David this year. I'm really upset. This is going to be a good send-off for him. He's been a fantastic player, really represented our team. The season has been had its ups and downs.
It's been a tough one for the men's twos.
But this is going to be a good end of year event.
I heard you were part of the men's first team as well. For the first match that Bath have lost in like what 10, 15 years or something.
Yeah, I'm glad. To so say that not a part of the reason for that.
Nah, that's a pretty crazy record to break, though. Like we're talking records about Harry Jones trying to get a donut. You're.
Wait, that is going on my CV right at the top.
No, actually, no one else is going to be able to do that for a long time now. That's the thing. Like,
they're just not built like me.
Yeah, it's just you've come along to Bath and cemented yourself as a
in the history books,
really.
Right, back to the games. I think it's already two down against Harry. That's strong. Sheps is putting in an absolute killer game. I don't think he's conceded. I don't know if he's conceded yet. I need to.
Nah, he's always a comfortable player though. And we were saying earlier as well, he's got his dissertation working on smash defense. Have you done that yet?
The VR one.
Yeah.
I have not.
I haven't either. I was thinking about it, but we were saying that's just practice, basically, for varsity.
Is his life.
Exactly, on and off the court. That's all he's thinking about.
All right. Luckily, we have one of our social managers coming in to say a few words for us.
No.
No. Go on. That is a beautiful smash from Jeff and from Harry Jones.
Strong defense from a Cardiff Met player, though. Oh, nearly put that away as well. I won't lie, Harry Jones did look like he was in a bit of trouble there. So this might not be as free of a win as he thought before.
So these are our second set of games. Unfortunately, I missed our first. Any comments from them?
What, the singles ones?
Yeah.
I mean, if we're doing a quick recap, it was 2-3 for Harry Jones. I mean, he's been putting in waist smashes like that the whole day. He's not looked like he's too under pressure. And then Sheps, I think it was 7-7. So consistent as ever. He's just here to have a good time, you know. A smile on his face, that's all he needs.
I haven't seen much showmanship from Harry.
Nah. There were a couple of like deceptive lifts in the first game. Might pull those out later. But I think especially seeing how this guy's playing.
He is putting up
he's putting him under a
Harry Jones is well he's Harry Jones.
Yeah.
I don't know what else to say. He is actually an extremely good player.
I mean, both of these guys were on the men's first team for Bath, who went on to win the Premier League and also reach the semi-finals of the National Cup. So, both pretty decorated players.
Decorated players, indeed.
Can't say the same for you, but it is what it is.
I use my talents elsewhere. You know.
I don't know where your talents are being used.
Looking pretty strong coming into the end of the first set for both of these players.
Yeah, all we needed one of these singles to be a win, and the badminton has gone the way of Bath.
Really hoping to get a post-match interview from one of these players. I know their timetable is very busy, celebrities as they are. So
I mean, yeah, I'm sure after this is back to the performance centre,
the grind,
back to training. You know, never stops.
See if we can get some comments from our faithful partner, Peter Eriksson. Would you like to say a few words to everybody back there?
Strong. Coach on after the
coach.
Yeah, JP. I'm actually so glad JP's coach because he's got. No, I'm not going to lie, I actually think I was out. But we'll take the point anyway.
So JP is head of our development, a new set.
We're bringing in new blood to Bath. So even though we're losing some very strong players next year, we've got just as many good ones coming in thanks to JP.
JP.
Basically 21 points away
from the first win. First scores in 21-1.
21-1, and that was the one shot that we saw at the very start. What for Sheps?
One of the mics they can't hit it might be mine. Oh. Could well be mine. And you're missing out on that fantastic commentary, which is tragic. Starting off the second set very, very well. Some fantastic games so far, and it's just been, not to say domination.
I think it is just domination.
The guy Harry's playing has put up a class game, but Harry is just.
He's put up a much better performance than I would have thought, to be honest. I wouldn't back myself to be doing too much better against him.
Doubles, though. They do have a few strong pairs.
Yeah, no, they're...
How was David and...
The pair that David and Anthony played were definitely the better pair. They are strong. Speaking to Harry Jones a bit, he said he used to know them on the tournament circuit, so they have got experience playing.
Circuit back in his day.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I heard you're back on the county circuit playing for, what was it, Avon 7th or something like that?
Man, you don't need to mention this stuff, man.
How is that going? I didn't know you could have seven teams for a county, but...
We're playing with the first team, actually. Or seconds, I don't know. We can check. But I won.
You won. What were you doing? Doubles or singles?
Doubles. I can't really slander Adam Hill because he is the Mr. Consistent for our team. So we had an awards night. This man won. Coach's choice.
Coach's choice, of course.
Player's choice.
And player's choice. It's just a clean sweep at that point.
Sweep. Shout out to Adam Hill. Love that guy. And so I've heard Adam Hill has a placement interview tomorrow.
Yeah, how no. Bit iffy. But you know what? It is what it is. It's about shining as an individual, just like football players are shining as individuals on the court right now.
That was beautiful. But he's just
that is beautiful from Cardiff Met, which means the donut is off the court.
The donut is off the court, and Harry Jones is shaking.
You can see his hand just moving slightly when he's waiting to receive the serve there. But yeah, still in control.
I am very pleased that we have got some good games today. Really good show.
What's your plans for the rest of the day? What other sports are you going to go watch?
I might go watch some swimming. I know some people in swimming. Very excited. Obviously, Bath. We're so strong in so many sports. I'm so excited to see. Maybe some rugby, actually. I heard Cardiff Met are very good at rugby.
Yeah, I think the rugby should be a good one.
But I don't see any reason to when the badminton is. You need to get Anthony over here to talk to him.
Oh, he's going to be going on in a minute.
I wonder if we can get some words from our coach, Pete Bush. Has he been
heard? Dan wanted to. He walked up these stairs. Dan wanted to get a couple words, but he politely declined, so maybe later on. And that's the first first match of the second set of singles over. Shep's taken it, which means Bath have 5-0. And the badminton has been won by Bath, so that's 1 point up in varsity. It's a great way to start the day.
Honestly, that has made my day. I'm already happy.
I mean, it's an omen of things to come, really.
An omen of things to come.
Starting off with winning ways.
From Adam
yeah. Hill. It's coming home for what would it be? For eighth consecutive time?
Well, there's quite a few. They had a lot of supporters on the Cardiff Met side. More than I expected. There was a very vocal man earlier, as I heard.
Yeah, no. But I think, football's... football's going on at the same time, so I know quite a lot of people are going down for that, because that's going to be a big one.
Is it going to finish by the end of this? Yes! Post-match interview. Can I hear from...
Yeah. Right. I mean, that's it secured, right? Five wins across all of the games.
Good performance from Bath. Well, good effort to Cardiff Met for keeping on going and giving their best try.
What were the scores in those two?
1-0.
What? Oh, he's got the donut secured as well.
Harry. Yeah, I have beaten Harry. To be fair, I think he may have hurt his ankle a bit.
Playing through an injury.
Yeah, so I mean, I think it was. But no, good effort to him to keeping on going.
Feeling confident with the doubles to come.
It should be a good match because Cardiff Met have pretty strong doubles players. I mean, after watching the first doubles.
Yeah, they did look pretty good.
Yeah, I thought that game could have definitely gone to Cardiff. So. Yeah.
What? It's not too bad.
Not too bad. Oh, doing 10 viewers.
Yeah, really.
To hear our wise words. That's a lot.
What's your plans for the rest of the day, though? Are you going to go watch some of the other ones?
Yeah, I mean, I'll have a look around. I mean, I don't usually get to watch the other sports, so I think it should be quite nice to have a wander around. I'm not really sure what else is on at the moment.
But you can be glad knowing you brought back a win for Bath, starting the day off well.
How's this game going?
Pretty chill as well. I don't think it's quite as low as a 1-0, but. I think he's taken this one more seriously as well compared to the other guy. Like, he's actually full smashing some of them, so.
Yeah, I think the guy I played, by the end.
Heart wasn't quite in it anymore.
Not so in it, yeah. This guy was quite good. I'm not sure his
name. Surname. Yeah, it's just... You're not getting that one back, really, are you? Put Joe Warren on the court. Even with his best dive, he's not getting that one back.
Some messages to Ryan, who's watching from back home. Hope you're enjoying the stream.
Yeah, shout out Ryan Coe.
Ryan Coe.
Now, if he was here, he would have pulled through with the results as well.
Did they finish the first set?
Yeah, this is second set.
Do you know what the score was in the first set? 5 or 6.
Yeah, something like that.
Dan called me and then I didn't actually listen to what he said.
That's just standard though.
So I'll pass the mic back to the
go on.
Professional commentary.
Oh, well, I just kind of walked in and Dan gave it to me, so... Alright, thank you, Adam, who is also our Hamilton chairman. Big shout out.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Bit of showboating from Harry here.
He's missed it.
Away.
Oh, double head, double hands on head from Coach Pete. He's not happy with that one. There's definitely going to be training related to that after this match.
Yeah. A few laps for maybe some suicide.
I think he's just gonna, words of encouragement from coach at the back there. I think he's just gonna try bring this one home now.
Maybe some wise words. Big smash and power, and it's done. Is that thing? But it's getting very close. We're gonna watch this out before our last set of doubles. Thank you again, everybody who's watching. It's been a blast having you. It's unfortunate. I think we're gonna let's watch these last few points together. See how. Oh, you can't, Harry. Can't tell. We'll play Harry. Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh my gosh, Harry Jones has lost a point. It's getting exciting now. So. Anything exciting going on in your house?
I mean, varsity's going on, man. Why wouldn't I be excited about that?
Did you get a chance to see any of our mascots today?
Not yet, but I will be keeping an eye out.
Managed to get a high five from the duck.
Did you actually?
I'm so happy. Right, I reckon this is 20 now. Let's see.
There it is.
Fantastic performance.
Oh, singles one.
Really good. That was
good showing. You can't be too disappointed against someone as good as Harry.
So that is 6-0 so far.
6-0. Four wins for the singles. Just two more doubles left to go. And hopefully we can bring back the 8-0 clean sweep.
To knock up.
Yeah, it's looking...
Pleasure to watch this player. We've already had a few words with him.
Few words.
I wasn't listening, but it did sound quite...
But he's... it was great to have him on the mic. And... He's a comfortable player, man. He knows what he's capable of. Feeling good for the doubles, then? I mean,
strong. I didn't know.
You're the resident doubles player, so I'm sure your insights.
I'm a substitute.
You can't hear this one.
Oh, okay.
This one.
Maybe just. Which one did I start?
I don't know.
That's what you can't hear.
Are you telling me that we're missing out on my fantastic commentary? That is awful.
Dude, it just sounds like I'm talking to myself then.
Just put the move, like, do the move.
I don't want to hold this one.
Yeah, just put it down. If you can't hear
it. Right, now me and Adam have to sit right next to each other. It's quite intimate. But...
It's always intimate. Anyone you want to give a shout out to?
Saga? Shout out to my partner Saga. performance this year has been outstanding. He's had to deal with me and his partner, which is a punishment for anybody, I'll be honest. But thanks, Saga. Shout out to my parents back home. Wouldn't be here without who else? My sister, who is a lot better than me at badminton. anyone else? And our coach, Pete Bush.
Oh yeah, big shout out to Pete Bush, of course. Only reason any of the players here are half as good as they are, you know? I heard Anthony didn't even know what a racket was until he pulled up and Pete Bush showed him, so...
Such wise words.
I think I've got some notes.
Some notes?
From,
what to talk about?
JP Miss Cool.
Fuck off.
Whoa, language.
My bad, bro.
They're all shit. I think we're getting the first doubles started.
Got some new arrivals, some new supporters. Glad to see the bar spirit is at its highest here.
JT, you look horrible.
Oh yeah, did you know one of the players down there is JT Thomas.
JT Thomas.
And we've got JP Thomas as our coach. That's
he hasn't even. I hope you haven't been drinking.
Right.
I'll see you tonight, Adam.
I mean, I'm only going for one because I've got the interview.
Tragic.
But I'll be there. Dude, I'm actually shaking.
Celebration drinks. Presumably to celebrate winning, but we have actually won now, so it's going to go well.
So I'd definitely say the one to watch is the left-hand court. That's Cardiff Mets. There's only so much you can do.
And luckily, we have over here Harry Jones, but post-match.
We can't do a post-match interview with one working.
Yeah, we can. Beautiful smash and Dankai. It's been a pleasure to watch today. Even though I was late. Are you thinking of watching any other sports today?
Yeah, I reckon I'll come through to a couple. I mean, football and rugby's going to be good. I think volleyball might be pretty good as well. And then, I'm not sure. I mean, obviously the Bath netball is pretty good. I don't know how strong Cardiff Met netball is. But if Cardiff Met netball is good, that could be pretty nice.
Bathampton is volleyball and netball is very good. Oh, beautiful.
No, nothing to worry about there for either players. You could see a little check over the shoulder from Dan just to see where Sam was, but you know deep down he knew.
He trusts his teammate.
They've been playing together for so long now that it's kind of, they function as one almost.
Symbiotic. Strong defense. Oh my God, Harry Jones has friends.
What?
What is going on? Yeah, but they turned up late enough to miss his only game, so unfortunate friendship there. That is out. This has been a close match so far. I'm really...
Oh, Cardiff team on the right, so I get a little pumped as well. It was a good shot, to be fair.
Oh, it's good to show some team spirit.
But I was saying... Oh, no. Okay, Anthony did just put that one away with ease.
Beautiful.
But in experience, you know, if that pair on the right-hand court is going down a few points...
Oh, Sam Cook, man.
You know, do they hold strong mentally? Or do they kind of crumble? Iron wills.
I don't see anyone crumbling here. With the training that we've been put through. Oh, my God. Harry Jones, hang on. We have to get a post-match interview.
Only one mic
works. How's he feeling? Yeah, this is the only mic that works.
Okay.
Just, you can give your shout-outs, yeah, no, you know.
You speak and then, you know.
I'll hand it over. I mean, we'll start off simply. What were the scores in those games?
So it was, I won 21-2 and 21-8.
Looked a little bit tougher than the first one, though.
Yeah.
Looks like you were giving it a little bit more effort than the first one, you know.
Definitely.
I mean, Chefs was saying he had a pretty good smash. What are you saying?
Yeah, he did have a good smash, to be fair. He didn't really smash much, but he should have used that a little bit more. Coming on in, he was actually, like, pretty decent in this. But yeah.
I mean, given the chances, he was putting away points, right?
Yeah, definitely. He was clinical when he could be, you know.
And then I saw one point, you know, had a little bit of a stroll back to the tee for the defense, smashed it through you. I think Pete had two hands on his head. He was distraught. You know,
that's the first reaction I've heard of him today, like reacting to my sort of badminton this morning. So yeah, that's quite interesting to know.
I mean, do you think there's going to be words afterwards? He's going to construct a training plan based on where you were going short here.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there's a lot to improve on after this performance. So you know, I'm sure he'll be cooking up some things to do in training. You know,
I mean, what? That's 6-0 already, right? So badminton's already won.
Yeah.
Starting the day off with a point.
Hopefully, we get the whitewash. You know, the 0, the 8-0.
Do you back the other doubles to take?
Yeah, I back the boys. You know, this one's starting off a little bit contested, but I'm sure they'll drift away with time. I mean, look at that. God. Sam's not been training, by the way. That's why he's doing that.
And then later on in the day, you're going to go watch any of the other sports? What's the plan?
Yeah, I'm definitely going to go watch the water polo. My housemate plays water polo and he's playing, so... You know, and he plays striker, so hopefully he bags a few goals.
Right.
I'm expecting lots of things from him, so yeah. But apart from that, probably, I don't know, maybe go watch like the rugby, maybe.
Yeah, might as well.
I don't know, we'll see.
Nice.
Thank you.
A huge thank you to Harry Jones.
Yeah, number one player in Bath right there. Oh!
Wow, that is disrespectful from Sam.
I don't think he even put a hand up there. A bit of lack of sportsmanship, you could say, but it is varsity, you know. Are you really going to try apologise to the enemy? You know, when you look across the net and you see the boys in red.
I see.
It's not...
There's no compassion here.
No, exactly.
Oh, I want to see how many viewers we have.
Bit of miscommunication from Cardiff Met on the right hand court.
Okay.
I think it's still looking fairly comfortable. Looking like the 8-0 could be coming home.
It is so definitely coming home. I think this game is actually very close. Oh, we're down to 8 watching. That is tragedy.
13, what do you mean?
Matthew Reed, Ryan Coe. No donors coming in.
Where's the donors? donate 10 quid and Joe will run across the court. Joe will streak across the court for 20.
I think you can watch it on Instagram as well, Joe. Unfortunate there, but Dan Kite's serve is...
Reminiscent of when I've played you in doubles, actually.
Really?
Returns like that. And then smashes like that just... Oh, I mean, David's looking just like... He doesn't even want to be here, almost. It's that confident in himself. Hand on the hip. He just wants to serve his way through this game and bring back the winter bath. I think we're first game through on the left-hand court. Dan and Sam taking that one. Halfway through to getting another doubles win.
that might loop.
Oh, dude, it's actually going to loop, isn't it?
All right. Fantastic play here.
Oh, just that over.
Net cord.
You know, I would have been happy with that.
Badminton England. I want to sound like that. You know.
Well, wait. Where you do a little? Ooh, big. It was a miscommunication. It was fucking perfect communication. They just knew it was out. Pretty nonchalant defense there from Sam. Cheeky little neck or drop off Dan as well.
What the f***ing... She's like, fantastic rally.
Splendid serve. Just narrowly... Yeah,
from a...
Yeah, we'll move over to there.
Oh, when they start.
Yeah. Cardiff Met getting a bit... Getting a bit vocal here. Something must be going on. We are meant to be watching, aren't we?
Yeah.
Fantastic play. Very casual defense. Sam's coming back slow, down the ball. It's a good rally.
It's almost like, oh! That was a big smash, to be fair. I think Victor Axelsson would have trouble defending that.
He would have a few comments. Sam should give him some pointers.
Ooh, did you see that net cord on the right hand side, bro? I thought David was going to throw hands on that one.
I wouldn't take it. Pete Bush is watching with his star first team players are having a bit of trouble.
I mean, he's been training these guys for months on this, so... He's got to make sure that the hard work pays off.
Clinical.
I need to be quiet around the mic, I'm sorry. Just getting too excited, man.
It's an exciting game.
Oh, very clear. Beautiful. They're letting them play a lot of an attacking shot. They're quite defensive this game.
Yeah, I think...
Man, there's the
smash. I mean, all he needs is one chance to put the shot away. That was splendid, honestly. Superb.
Managed to get it. On the back foot here. Nice defense.
Good lift, gets him out of trouble.
Very calm here. Walking back into that.
Oh, good save from Dan there. Ooh, great defense. Oh, sublime. Clapping from Pete Bush. That is, I don't think I've ever seen that before. He only pulls that out for brilliant shots.
Once in a blue moon, Pete Bush.
Honestly,
pleased with something that.
You may not see a shot like that ever again in your life. That's how good it was. Oh, to be fair, they're clapping back with a couple of tight net shots, you know.
Their supporters are
the Cardiff Met supporters are right behind the players.
Love the enthusiasm. It is varsity. Everybody just about having a bit.
And you got Ice Spice in the background, you know. There's nothing that quite gets you in the zone like Ice Spice.
Definitely know his players.
I mean, if you're in Dan Kite's position here,
it's getting shaken. The mental game is going. What a shot!
Bro, I'm seeing some really nice shots. You know,
exquisite.
I wasn't seeing this against Warwick first, but as soon as he's playing Cardiff Met in varsity, he's on a different level.
go to three.
Peter's getting worried. He's tapping his chair.
Yeah, a little bit of twitching. Good return though. Oh, it's just like that is a really nice shot from Sam. Then you've also got to give Dan credit for setting him up for it, you know. Cheeky little return and then shots away. It's almost a repeat of the last point.
So casual.
Oh, there's table tennis.
Coach Pete is very pleased.
Is that another ping? I'm not going to lie, I think we're up to like 3 or 4 pings on the Cardiff Met players. Like, it's actually, you got to ask yourself if they're trying to now.
I thought this was yours now. Our side is crumbling in this first team. I have full faith though.
Oh, we got a Cardiff Met player on the...
I know that, I'm sure the score is quite comfortable. We'll see how it's going. Fires out. Oh, gosh.
Nah, I don't know. Tides could be turning a little bit here. You know, we've seen some beautiful shots from Sam, but they're starting to make mistakes as a pair now. And hearing the roar of a crowd behind you can't help.
Oh, you can't discount the home advantage, though. That was...
Oh,
so
that was fucking... That's cold, bro. You can't be doing that. Oh, he turns around as well.
Turns around.
Nah, he's a player's player, man.
Sport is somewhat lacking this side, it seems. Beautiful shot.
Oh. Ooh.
They're just
going for another net court.
Can't copy what Dan has.
Nah.
It's like you're either born with it or you don't have the skill. Dan has the skill, it seems like the Cardiff Met players, just they don't have it.
Just being setting up the defense until they make mistakes.
Nice little back. Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I think that's a third or fourth time.
We've seen that Cardiff Met guy on the floor. It needs
it's
to.
Right. They seem to be targeting.
I mean, David. I know David. Last year, he was building spreadsheets to try to figure out the players.
Over-analyzing their movements.
Exactly.
Just stands there and stares at them.
Yeah, no. But that's what works for him, you know. Another mistake, bro.
Unfortunate. The score must be very close.
Does look like it's teeing up a bit on the left-hand court.
Got our main three sat on the table. If you can see them on our live stream, we have JP on the far left.
Oh, another ping, but I actually think we're up to like 5 pings now.
We have Adam Shepherd in the middle and we have Coach Pete on the right. Those are the 3 pillar stones of badminton.
Top dogs, you've got the development
mafia.
Development and varsity coach. Chairman and women's freeze coach. And then main squad coach as well, you know.
Top dog. Very casual.
No, it's both pairs looking comfortable as well. Got to see who makes the first move.
Dan seems to keep giving them back the attack. He seems to enjoy
another clear. Another clear. Oh, he mixed up with a drop.
Sam playing it. He likes that shot. Beautiful block.
Oh.
Kept out the back. That's so out.
Oh, no. He can't be doing that for.
He can't be doing that.
One time, you know, you say, okay, that's kind of cold. Dude, he's looking around as well. He's doing it for the crowd.
He loves it.
He's trying to get in there. He's trying to get in the heads, and I love it.
Maybe the star player today.
And we can see on the right hand side as well. David and Anthony have won that game, 7-0 for Bath.
7-0 for Bath.
Simply just a formality now to see if we can get the 8-0 clean sweep. Strong lift. They do have good attack, to be fair, but when you're playing against with
too casual.
He's making me look bad. I was about to say defense as strong as theirs, but then he's pulling things out like that. The only benefit is, though, it does seem to be mistakes from Bath rather than being outplayed.
Slight communication error there. Noah has a few things to say, actually. Unfortunate. Hoping to see a turnaround for Bath here.
Oh. There's one back, you know. Just need a bit of change of momentum. Doesn't look like that's going to be the case, though. If Cardiff Met keep this momentum in their favour, then...
They've been fighting very well. Huge smash.
Yeah, big smash from Dan Kaivo. Played in the Bath Bronze this weekend, as we said earlier. He went home with the golden singles.
Took it home, man. And he also played in the doubles. Didn't hear about...
We don't talk as much about the doubles, but in terms of singles, came home with a gold.
That is a fantastic result from our pride.
And that
is game.
Perfectly in the back box, that's game. That's 8-0 for Bath. A great way to start off varsity.
Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Our amazing fans. We didn't...
Yeah, thanks for watching the badminton broadcast. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you. Thank you. amazing how